Special presentation, the 1998 East Coast Music Awards.
Hello there, Canada. I'm Rick Mercer, and I'm about to host the 10th annual East Coast Music Awards. Now, we've still got some time, and like most people in Halifax, when I got a few minutes to kill, there's nothing I like to do better than to take a quick walk across the bridge there and stroll down to Cape Breton and have a cup of tea.
That's very nice. Good.
Hello. Could you please tell me, is your refrigerator running? Well, don't you think you better go out and catch it, dear? Full house.
Does that beat a 3 and a 9?
Oh, yes, dear. Uh-oh. We better get going. We're going to be late. I'll drive.
Thank you. Okay, let's go.
You better put on your seatbelt, dear.
From the Metro Center in Halifax, Nova Scotia, the 10th annual East Coast Music Awards, with performances by Ashley McIsaac, Rita McNeil, Sloan, Julian Austin, Lenny Gallant, Bruce Guthrow, Ron Hines, the Johnny Favorite Swing Orchestra, Jamie Sparks, Karen Corman, Modabo, and Symphony Nova Scotia. The 1998 ECMAs are brought to you in part by Alexander Keith's India Pale Ale. Those who like it a lot. And by the province of Nova Scotia. Celebrate the best music in Canada all year long. Ladies and gentlemen, 7-time ECMA winner, Lenny Gallant.
Hands on deck, please don't panic. It's probably a drill, there's really nothing wrong. Steady as she goes on the Titanic. It can't be too bad, the band plays on. Ba-da-ba-ya, ba-da-ba-da, ba-da-ba-ya, ba-da. There's apples launched upon the water. Captain's crying, oh, won't you please get in? I don't believe in this disaster. I just can't believe the mess we're in. And the band's still playing. Can you hear those horns? Crying out for our souls. And the band's still playing. Arrange all of the deck chairs. I'm gonna cover my head every inch of skin. Trading in my sunglasses for a darker pair, so I won't have to see the mess we're in. And the band's still playing. Can you hear those horns? Crying out for our souls. And the band's still playing. The band made hymns. Rock and roll.
got me dancing so fast. You know I really ain't got time to think. Someone said something about a big hole in the sky. Someone said last call, time for one more drink. And the band's still playing. Can you hear those horns crying out for our souls? And the band's still playing. The band made hymns. And the band made rock and roll. And the band's still playing. Can you hear those horns crying out for our souls?
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your host for this evening. One of the stars of this hour has 22 minutes, Rick Mercer.
Well, good evening, Halifax. Yeah. And to everyone who's watching and listening on the CBC National Network, from Conception Bay, Newfoundland, to Kamloops, British Columbia. How y'all doing? That's great. Welcome to the 10th annual East Coast Music Awards. What a great opening number, eh? Wasn't that something? And you know, that's the amazing thing. That's a true story, of course. The band on the Titanic actually kept playing as the boat went down. So I guess there was still some beer left. Yeah. Yeah. They were a good band, too, apparently. Yeah. Not a very smart band. But, you know, they were pretty good. Did you see the movie? Did you see the movie? Wow, eh? What a surprise ending, though. I mean, it was like The Crying Game or something. Turns out in the end, Leonardo DiCaprio has a penis. Man. So tonight we are here, of course, to celebrate another great year of East Coast music. A lot has happened since the last ECMAs. This was the year of the merger, of course. The Royal Bank. Yeah, the Royal Bank merged with the Bank of Montreal. The lead singer of the Irish Descendants punched out the fiddle player. He got up merged with the guitar player from the wonderful Grand Band. They got an album coming out. It was the year, of course, of Nova Scotia's own Sarah McLachlan. Yeah. Yeah. And of course, she took North America by storm with Lilith Fair. Amazing. And of course, as we all know here, of course, Lilith Fair actually an old Gaelic word. For I just made $14 billion. Yeah. And Sarah really wanted to be on the show tonight, of course, but she said it would have interfered with her UIC claim. So, there you go, them's the breaks, you know. Of course, it was the year, this year, that everyone got upset about cloning. Except here on the East Coast, of course, you know, where we were thinking, hey, today Dolly the sheep, tomorrow Cookie the Rankin. Then we'll rise again. Of course, it's just great to be on this stage tonight, sharing this stage with all these great musicians, because, you know, for a guy like me who, you know, can't sing or dance or make any kind of music whatsoever, I'm like a Spice Girl, really. You know. Really, I am. Yeah. Well, Old Spice, anyway. We got a great show for you, and we're going to kick it off now. To present our first award, Roots Traditional Vocalist of the Year, are the hosts of last year's ECMAs in Moncton. You know her. She's a five-time ECMA winner who's wowed audiences at home and abroad. And he is the lead singer of New Brunswick's Les Méchants Macareux. Please welcome the lovely Natalie McMaster and Roland Gauvin.
Welcome to Halifax.
Salut tout le monde et bienvenue à Halifax. Salut tous les Acadiens aussi.
Kimba de Howe. Well, we're quite pleased to be up here. It kind of reminds me of last year, eh? Gives me a good feeling.
Yeah, I'm starting to get a hosting rush right now. Actually, you know what I think, Natalie? I'm enjoying this so much, maybe we should take over the show. There's teleprompters right there.
Yeah, that'd be great, but what about Rick?
Well, Rick won't mind. Rick's a nice guy. He's get paid anyway. We'll give him the cash. We'll do the show. Here, let me try it.
I don't think we
Mesdames
go.
Et messieurs.
No, Roland, let it go!
Pour présenter la...
Roland, contain control yourself. Guess what? There's a 2-4 and a couple of cod backstage. Want to go have a feed?
How many cod?
A couple.
All right, let's go.
Anyway, let's roll the nominations.
Among the nominees for Roots Traditional Vocal Artist of the Year are Celtic Connection. J.P. Cormier. Dave Gunning. McKeel. And Laura Smith. Such a surprise. I'm a
beauty. Let's see.
They're going on air, and the winner is...
Here, Nathan.
J.P. Cormier!
If I could only fly, if I could build a bridge, I'd carry you my love across this barren bridge.
Well, well, well. Guess my arse. I'm speechless, but I'll attempt to stumble through something here. I want to thank my manager, Max McDonald and Rave Entertainment. There's no other management company in the world like those guys. Paul Mills, my cousin Gervais Cormier, Adrian O'Coyne, Dave Gunning, all great musicians who played with us in the last 3 years, and my wife, Hilda Chasson. I wouldn't be here without her. And thanks be to God Almighty who gave me my talent and gave all of us our talent. Thank you very much.
If I could only fly, if I could build a bridge.
Coming up, honoring the ECMA's Group of the Year and performances by Rita McNeil, Ashley McIsaac, and Sloan.
This is, in fact, the 10th anniversary of the ECMAs. But a bit of trivia here for you now. Not many people are aware that the original name was, in fact, the Bonnies. Yeah, the Bonnies. However, after a long deliberation, the board of directors just decided that ECMA was a much prettier name. ECMA. Now, you probably do know that many winners of the ECMA have gone on to great international success. Take, for example, our next performers. Chart magazine called them the most important band of the decade. Please put your hands together, folks, and welcome Sloan. They got a shot of the premiere during that because he was moshing. Man, he was wild. Now this Moncton singer currently has a top 10 country hit with Haven't You Heard? And he is a member of Prince Edward Island's Barrochois 1997's Francophone Artist of the Year. To present the ECMA for Group of the Year, here's Shirley Myers and Chuck Arsenault.
Personally gives me an opportunity to congratulate you on your award winnings last year. Way to go.
I'd like to personally thank you, Shirley, for breaking my shoulder.
Sorry.
This also gives me a chance to congratulate you on having Canadian country music's top 5 single of the year.
Thank you. radio certainly let it rain last year.
They certainly did.
Your hair's still wet.
And the nominees for Group of the Year are...
For Group of the Year, nominees are... Great Big C. The Johnny Favorite Swing Orchestra.
I'm going to the town, I'll spend my money there. We go!
McKeel. Modabo. And the punters.
And the 1998 East Coast Music Awards Group of the Year winner is...
Hang on! Great Big C.
Shall I go?
Start off, sir.
Thank you. Thanks very much. Group of the Year. This is excellent. It's good to be in our home away from home. Beautiful Halifax, Nova Scotia. Excellent. You sure know how to throw a good party. This is, I think, the third time we've been here, and every year it gets more and more special. There's 100 million people we could thank. First of all, we'd like to thank our girls and families who are at home, no doubt, pining somewhere in a St. John's house. God bless them. Give them a round of applause because they deserve it.
We'd like to thank particularly Warner Music Canada, who worked so hard and believed so much in the music of Atlantic Canada. We'd particularly like to thank Louis Thomas, Tony Pitcher, and Danny, who worked so hard for us. Thank you all.
Music on the East Coast is certainly a big industry now. When we were growing up, it was, I don't think we ever looked to be big stars, and it was just more or less part of our human existence. And we had a lot of fun playing music and sharing our music.
Music is pretty well our whole life, so if it wasn't important in the East Coast, our life would be pretty much different.
Somewhere in the middle, I think. People get it. People play bingo or go to casinos, but I think music's definitely in the top three. And I think a lot of people have come to the East Coast. I remember back in sometime in the mid '80s when I talked about using music as a tourism ploy for Cape Breton. A lot of people laughed at me. It's purely a cultural thing, but culture is tourism. Tourism is. It's getting people together, and the more people we can get together, be it here or around the world.
The bigger the Kaylee is.
The bigger the Kaylee, the better the music.
Coming up, single of the year. Closed captioning for the 1998 East Coast Music Awards is provided by Alexander Keith's India Pale Ale.
Well, it's so amazing. It's so amazing being backstage there among all of these musicians, you know. It's like another world back there. And there's all of this terminology you have to know before you even understand what's going on, you know? You have your 16th note, allegro, modulation, alimony, bong, subpoena. It's hard to tell what's going on back there. Now, although many people associate East Coast music with your traditional Celtic sound, the style of music produced here is very diverse. For example, Karen Corbin of Pictou County hit number one on the dance charts last year with High on Love. And Jamie Sparks is a one-man recording industry making huge waves in the R&B scene. And of course, Johnny Maniacs Everywhere have been known to cut the occasional rug to the Johnny Favorite Swing Orchestra. Now, if you don't want to dance, nail your feet to the floor, folks. And please welcome Karen Corbin, Jamie Sparks, and the Johnny Favorite Swing Orchestra.
Cents to spare. Sometimes I dance all night, sometimes I wouldn't dare. Preparing leg fresh, 50 cents to spare. I'm going to the candy store, get my candy there. Preparing leg fresh, 50 cents to spare. Sometimes I swing all night, sometimes I couldn't dare. Preparing leg fresh, 50 cents to spare. I'm going to the tavern, I'll spend my money there. Here we go! Hut! 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 Thank you.
is by your side. My feelings cannot be denied. I gotta tell you now, I'm falling further in love.
There was no fiddles in that. Our next presenter. She's delivered more than 100 live performances last year, including being a part of Lilith Fair. And he is a 6-time ECMA winner and one of Canada's most loved performers. To present the award for Single of the Year, please welcome Tara McLean and Mr. Terry Kelly.
Thank you. Hi, we're here to present Single of the Year.
Single of the Year? Mm-hmm. Tara, I thought you were Single of the Year.
Oh. Oh, dear.
Hi. You know, I've been traveling across this country for the last year presenting my We Can Do Anything presentation to thousands of students, and I have noticed that there are a lot of students and teachers concerned about the pull out of music and the arts in schools. And I think it's really Tara and I have discussed this, and we really feel it's important for young people, particularly junior high and high schools, because there's a lot of involvement in elementary school, but parents of junior high and high schools, let your government people know how you feel about this. And I think the Atlantic Canadian governments can start the ball rolling for the rest of the country. All right.
I know if it wasn't for the creative influences that I had in school with some of my teachers, Ms. McNeil and Monsieur Poirier, I know I wouldn't be standing here today.
And Ms. Hubley, Ms. McCurdy, and Dr. Farrell, thank you all. Now, here's why we need it, because there'll be more singles of the year, right?
Just like these, and the nominees are.
For Single of the Year, the nominees are Building a Mystery, artist Sarah McLaughlin, producer Pierre Marchand. Everything You've Done Wrong by Sloan, producer Lawrence Curry. Fiddle and Bow, Natalie McMaster and Bruce Guthrow, producer Chad Urshick. It's a Personal Thing, Laura Smith, producer Laura Smith and David Hillier.
Yeah, joy. It's a personal thing.
And When I'm Up, Great Big C, producer Danny Greenspoon.
And the winner of Single of the Year is When I'm Up, Great Big C.
Of affection. I'm the instrument of joy to keep the good times rolling. I'm the boy, I'm the boy. You know the world can be our oyster. Just put your trust in me.
Oh, he's coming. Mr. Doyle is soon to be here. Ah, oh, there he is.
Thank you.
Thanks, Alan. I don't know. Oh, there's Bob and Daryl, too. I think a special thanks for this award goes to our producer, Danny Greenspoon, who produced Up and Play. Thank you very much, Danny. We're very overwhelmed. Thanks for this, and thanks to the ECMAs. Thanks especially to our friends at Much Music for playing the video and CMT for playing the videos. Thank you very much. Danny, I think you should have a word. He's an honorary Newfoundlander now. He spent so much time with us.
I'm proud of it.
Here we go.
No, it's okay. I do have to thank these guys, first of all, for calling me when they did. It was an honor to work with them. They bring a passion and a respect for the music of Newfoundland that's totally contagious. They're wonderful ambassadors. Thank you very much.
I have a very, very special memory of the ECMAs. I think it was 2 years ago. I came here with Aaron Davis, my piano player. I've been playing with him for as long as I've been playing. And we did a duet of I'm So Lonesome I Could Cry, which is my grandfather's favorite song. And he taught me that song when I was just a little girl on accordion. And he was in the audience watching it, and it was just, for me, it was just an incredible experience. He was 80 years old. And he loved it. He cried, and I cried, and it was just a wonderful thing to do, because I love that song so much, and it's meant so much to me for so long. And he's an accordion player himself, my grandfather, and still plays. And it was, you know, one of the earliest memories I have here in Halifax is of my grandfather teaching me that song. So that was a very special night.
Next, New Brunswick's Modabo and the Dance Hip Hop Artist of the Year Award.
Hi, everybody. Sorry I can't be with you to celebrate your 10th anniversary, but I would like to send my sincere congratulations to all of tonight's nominees. I'm proud to be one of you. Here's to the next 10 years of celebrating our great musical heritage.
This Fredericton trio first won acclaim with their stirring rendition of the Stan Rogers classic, Northwest Passage. And since then, their boundless energy, their soaring harmonies have gotten them a highly enthusiastic following. To perform Boomerang, say hello to Modabo!
Love like a boomerang.
She is Canada's voice of liberal guilt. She's just released her latest CD, Gaelic Envy and Other Torch Songs. He is the lead singer of Newfoundland's latest sensation, The Punters, and they are one of the nominees tonight for Group of the Year. Please welcome Nancy White and Larry Foley.
So, Larry, I guess the last time that you and I shared a stage was at Lincoln Center in New York City.
We certainly get around, don't we?
Yes, we do.
Well, getting around is one thing, but this next group of artists certainly know how to
get down.
Roll them.
For Dance Hip Hop Artist of the Year, nominees are Bonshaw. Jam standing tall against the wall, looking for a mate to get hooked on your bait. Get your groove on and one way. Karen Corbin. Hal Harbour. Shy Love.
If you keep smiling, you know somebody will smile back. Everybody needs a day when they don't feel they could, but keep on smiling because you know that smile.
And Jamie Sparks.
And the winner is...
Jamie Sparks!
Well, obviously I'm not used to this, so I think I brought a just-in-case list. Just in case, I did. Okay. I'd like to thank everybody at the ECMAs, members of staff, everybody who voted for me, CBC, Solar Audio, Sustain Audio, International Clothers, Shelly Fashion, Smash Track Productions, my company, my vice president and manager, Rochelle. Thank you. Austin Price, our graphics designer. I'll just shake your hand when I see you. George Dukakis, everybody home in Cherrybrook, how you doing? Lake Loon, my Western family in North Preston, East Preston, how y'all doing? And a special thanks to, well, of course, my dancers and singers here. How y'all doing? Can't remember your names. But William, Bobby, Zeke, Sassy, Lady K, Susan. And I also want to give a special thanks to two people who have been instrumental in my career. They've always been supporting me and going to all my, well, trying to get to all my performances, always encouraging me with my music. And those two people are my parents, Evelyn and Ralph Sparks. My father's here. My mother's home. Hi, Mom. Thank you, everybody.
During the pre-telecast portion of tonight's gala, some of the winning East Coast artists were Country Artist of the Year, Julian Austin. Roots Traditional Instrumental Artist of the Year, Richard Wood. Bluegrass Artist of the Year, Exit 13. Francophone Recording of the Year, Liberi by Michelle Boudreau-Sampson. Pop Rock Artist of the Year, Great Big C.
Coming up on the 1998 East Coast Music Awards, the Blues Gospel category, and
and a performance by Bruce Guthrow.
ECMA Songwriter of the Year is a very difficult and a very prestigious award to win because, in fact, there's only about three people in Atlanta, Canada, who aren't great songwriters. You might meet them a little later on. They're the accountants Lyle Tilly Davidson. And actually, to be fair, you know, they're not that bad if you like a dirty drinking song, so. It always comes down to taste, really. Our next performer was, in fact, last year's ECMA Songwriter of the Year to perform Falling, the next single from his brand new album, Of Your Son. It is my great pleasure to introduce to you Cape Breton's own Bruce Guthrow.
Could you meet me at the station? There's something I would like to talk to you about. It's just this thing that has been on my mind forever. And I was hoping we could find a way to work it out. Oh, by the way, this is Martin. Just in case you have forgotten what I sound like, yeah, it's been a long, long time. They say that absence helps the heart grow fonder. Ah, well, anyway, I'd like to see you. Your son. Hey, I will be in town tomorrow. Could you meet me at the station? There is something I would like to talk to you about.
Bruce was joined by Symphony Nova Scotia, whose arrangements tonight are by Scott McMillan. Yes, it's a good thing you applauded, because you know what they say about Symphony Nova Scotia. They'd sooner punch you in the face and look at you. They're a hard crowd, the Symphony. I'm afraid to turn my back here. How you doing? Who with the ball, right? Between them, our next two presenters have gotten more laughs than Jean Charest and Elsie Wayne combined. She is the queen of East Coast comedy, one of the funniest women I've ever had the pleasure of working with, and he is the star of the upcoming new series, Daily Tips for Modern Living. Please welcome Bette McDonald and my buddy from 22, Greg Toomey.
Merci beaucoup.
Hi.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, and thank you, Rick. Thank you.
Yeah, he's doing a great job, Rick. Eh?
Yes.
Whatever.
Yeah. And that's a really nice toupee he has on. You can't tell. You know, musicians, they have a lot to teach us. For example, what was it Jimmy Rankin taught you?
Ooh, how to open a minibar with a paper clip and a stick of gum.
You know, some people take, that guy gives. He gives.
Yeah, and one of your favorites is nominated tonight,
yes,
Greg.
Yes, tonight, Kenny Rogers singing The Gambler. You got to know when to hold him. Everyone, know when to fold all the ladies. Know when to walk away. Oh, I stand corrected. Kenny Rogers, that's my agent in the audience, thank you. Kenny Rogers, not from the East Coast at all. He's actually from a place called hell.
You know, ladies and gentlemen, we had a lovely meal backstage.
Oh, yes, the musicians. Oh, we all sat down, had a potluck. Ron Hines brought his chili. Food fit for a king. Here, king, here, king. Hey, stick a tuning fork in me. I think I'm done.
And the nominees are...
The Blues Gospel Artist of the Year nominees are... The Black Cultural Center, various artists. Carson Downey and Big City. The Glamour Puss Blues Band. Scott Gowdy and Neil Bishop. And Rick Jeffrey.
Okay, and the winner is
Glamour Puss Blues Band.
Yeah.
Woo-hoo.
Yeah.
Well, we're just a little excited about this. Man, we've worked really hard since the inception of this band, and a lot of that hard work has to go to this man right here, Mr. Ron Dupuy. Thank you very much, Ron. We wouldn't be where you are, where we are, without you. We like to think that we represent the blues very well here in the Maritimes. Are part of the maritime music weight that falls on our shoulders. We're very proud to thank other people too. Hayward Parrott, he helped produce this album. The man is a massive talent, and we're very, very proud to be associated with him. Families, well, our families have chipped in so much. Michelle, Mom and Dad, you're out in the audience tonight. I love you all very much. Everybody out there in TV land, that's our families that is watching. We couldn't have done it without you. Everybody has to realize that the family of a musician is very patient and puts up with a lot. And we'd like to thank you guys. Anybody else with anything else to say? All right, Ron, go for it.
Yes, j'aimerais te remercier tous les Acadiens qui ont voté pour nous autres. I'd like to thank all the Acadians because we also have a little bit of that in our style. Thank you.
And now we come to the most important part of the show. Ballots for the East Coast Music Awards are tabulated by the accounting firm of Lyle Tilly Davidson. The files that contain the results are then eaten by members of the firm to ensure the utmost secrecy. On behalf of Lyle Tilly Davidson, please welcome the guy in the office who drew the short straw. Merck Perkhill. Yay, Merck!
Coming up, Rick's recipe for winning an East Coast Music Award, the Male and Female Artists of the Year, and a song by Julian Austin.
Well, if you're like me, by now you're sitting there and you're saying to yourself, man, I would really like to win myself one of those ECMAs. But you're saying to yourself, Rick, how do I go about doing it? Well, if you're like me and you have absolutely no musical talent whatsoever, that could be a bit of a problem. So what you gotta do is get yourself some music lessons. Now, seeing as we are on national TV, and who knows, the finance minister could be watching, who knows, we're gonna go with the barter system.
What? Oh, hi, Rick.
Natalie McMaster. Hi, Natalie. I'm here for the fiddle lesson.
Got $20? The barter system?
Yes, okay. Yeah.
Mimi, this is Rick. Rick, meet Mimi.
Hi, Mimi.
Hi.
Hi, nice to meet you.
You too.
Yeah? I actually thought it would be a private lesson, but, you know, first time lesson?
Yep.
Yeah, that's okay then. Teach me that, because I got that pretty well, right? Teach me that. Can you do that?
What's in it for me?
So all you gotta do is you gotta walk towards the camera, walk and talk about something that really bugs you.
You know what really bugs me about actors?
Cut! That's good, but it's better if it's something that bugs you, but also bugs everyone else. Bugs everyone else.
Okay. Okay, you know what really bugs everyone about actors?
No, cut, stop. Maybe you could just let me hold one of your ECMAs and we could just...
No.
No? No. Want to dance?
Maybe.
Thank you. That's why they call me the Lord of the Dance. Pretty wicked. Her group is on the verge of receiving national distribution for its hard-driving Celtic album, Plaid. And he is a member of the Newfoundland group twice voted ECMA Entertainer of the Year. The band's album, Play, has just gone multi-platinum. Please welcome, you know who I'm talking about, Fleur Mainville, and from Great Big Sea, Alan Doyle.
Fleur. Okay. You look lovely. Smashing.
Thank you. You look great as usual.
Thank you. The band is doing amazing. I heard your song in Newfoundland. I heard your song all across the country, doing very well. Look out for the new release from the band.
Thanks. And you guys are doing well as well.
Yep.
Excuse me.
Sorry.
Cleaning up again as usual.
I like it.
Yeah. And I hear you just got back from a European tour.
It was excellent. It was great fun, spreading Newfoundland music around over there. And the people are really friendly over there, I must say. We're touring around in France, and I don't know if you know, but like, just like it is in parts of French Canada, it's like customary greeting, it's like two kisses. And in Germany and parts of Poland, it's customary to give like three kisses on introduction. So if you can back me up on it, there's a sort of started the rumor that it's customary in Atlantic Canada to have 37 kisses and a slow dance.
For Female Artist of the Year are
the Female Artist of the Year nominees are Mary Jane Lamond, Tara McLean, Sarah McLachlan, Anne Murray, and Laura Smith.
And we're back, I believe. And, ladies and gentlemen, the receiver of the Female Artist of the Year is Sarah McLachlan.
I'm really flattered to win this award. I'm really sorry I can't be there, but I'm on a promotional trip in Japan. Just want to say that all the nominations are really great in this category, and I congratulate them all. Cheers.
Moving briskly along,
yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'll have a look at the nominees for Male Artist of the Year.
I'm getting right in.
For Male Artist of the Year, the nominees are J.P. Cormier, Johnny Favorite, I'm going to the town, spend my money there. Here we go. Lenny Gallant, Ron Hines, and Rock Was In. With these everything to me.
And the winner for Male Artist 1998 at the ECMAs is Lenny Gallant. My
Oh, this is fabulous. Now I think I know what I meant when I wrote, but I'm by ya ya. That's correct. I want to thank, first off, David Traversmith and Janet Munson, who helped me produce the last album, Lifeline. I want to thank all the musicians who played on the album, and my band, Chris McFarlane, Luke Morris, Chris Corrigan, Mike Cowie, Al McCumber, and I want to thank also various people who've helped in making the record, Bruce McNaughton, Mark Ledwell, all my family, Mark, my brother especially, and Amy Stewart. I want to thank Radio for playing it and all the fans for coming out to the shows. Thank you very much.
Next up, an artist from St. John, New Brunswick, who smothered every country chart in Canada last year with Little Old Kisses. And he's been recently honored with the Canadian Country Music Association's Rising Star Award. One of the most polite men I've ever had the pleasure to meet. And it's a good thing, too, because look at the arms. He could snap me in half. Please welcome Julian Austin.
I don't come around here. I tell me these lies. When no. Like a girl every time. You can look so sweet the way you look at me. And all it takes is one kiss and then I'm weak. Just one, honey. Hey. So I don't need your little old kiss. I don't need your little old lies. I don't need your little old promises. Or breaking my little heart twice. You've been gone, little, I ain't that sad. So I don't need your little kisses that bad.
Yeah, I do. So cool, you do so easily. Yet sometimes I think the devil, he's a she. So don't come around here and tell me these lies. Yes, I'm through being your little fool for last time. Ah, oh, that's right. So I don't need your little old kisses, don't need your little old lies. I don't need your little old promises of breaking my little heart twice. I've got strong since you've been gone. Little, I ain't that sad. So I don't need your little old kiss that bad. Oh, no, no, no. I don't need your little old kiss that bad. Oh, no, 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 no. I don't need your little old kiss that bad.
Still ahead, a special Ashley MacIsaac Hayley and the album of the year.
Happy anniversary, ECMA.
To present our next award, one is a founding member of an a cappella group whose songs draw on the rich tapestry of African Nova Scotian history. The other is a member of a Cape Breton group that blazed trails in the European market last year and is now working on its seventh album. Please welcome, from For the Moment, Delvina Bernard, and from the Barra McNeils, Lucy McNeil.
Lucy, I'm just so excited to see all these different categories and genres of music being represented here tonight.
Isn't it wonderful? And I'd like to congratulate you on your award.
Thank you. Now, I heard that the Bears delivered a fiery, hot, electrifying set recently at the Cohen.
And I believe you had the same experience.
Well, I mean, just to go a little further, I heard that it was so fiery that the sound system blew up.
When you're hot, you're hot.
Well, we're here to present the album of the year, which is great. And the nominees are...
The nominated recordings for Album of the Year are It's a Personal Thing by Laura Smith. Producers, Laura Smith and David Hillier. Lifeline by Lenny Gallant. Producers, Lenny Gallant and David Travis Smith. Play, Great Big C. Producer, Danny Greenspoon. Suisei, Mary Jane Lamond. Producer, Philip Strong and Laurel McDonald. And Surfacing, Sarah McLaughlin. Producer, Pierre Marchand.
I don't care what you say, that sound is like Bill Nye the Science Guy. I don't know. Either that or Carmen Sandiego. And the winner is... Play!
It's Great the end of the world as we know it, and I feel fine. That's great, it starts with an earthquake, birds, snakes, and aeroplanes. Lenny Bruce is not afraid.
Thank you. Daryl, good man.
We'd like to take the opportunity right now to thank all the fans who, the people all around in this room and right across the country for supporting Play and our other albums. Last year, in 1997, my father left this world for bigger and better things. So, Patty, this one's for you.
It's the end of the world as we know it, and I feel fine. That's great, it starts with an earthquake, birds, snakes, and aeroplanes. Lenny Bruce is not afraid.
Well, you know, some people were Celtic when Celtic wasn't, well, as cool as it is these days. Buddy McMaster and Winnie Chafe were Celtic when it wasn't even called Celtic music. It was called, music, I think. And their love of music has inspired players like John Morris Rankin and Dave McIsaac, who have inspired kids like Mark Boudreau and Samantha Robichaux, for example. Now, if you had all these people over to the house there for what they call a Kaylee, and then you were to invite along a virtuoso like, say, oh, I don't know, maybe your Natalie McMaster, and then you threw in the man who sold more than 300,000 copies of his first album, and single-handedly made it very cool to be Celtic. Now, if you had all these people in one place, that's a party that could go on longer than, yes, even this introduction. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my great pleasure to welcome to the East Coast Music Awards, Buddy McMaster, Winnie Chafe, Natalie McMaster, John Morris Rankin, Dave McIsaac, Mark Boudreau, Samantha Robichaux, and Ashley McIsaac.
Thank you.
Now, there were fiddles in that. Our next presenters. She gave Bonnie Raitt a number one hit when she wrote the song, Let's Give Them Something to Talk About. He's the principal songwriter for the most awarded act in ECMA history with 14 so far. Here are Shirley Eichardt and Jimmy Rankin of the Rankin Family.
Well, Jimmy, it'll take us far too long for us to discuss our love affair tonight, so I think we'll get right to it. What do you
think? We don't want to come out just yet, and it's getting late, so go ahead.
Okay. We're here to present the SoCan Songwriter of the Year Award, and the nominees are...
The SoCan Songwriter of the Year nominees are Alan Doyle and Sean McCann of Great Big Sea for Ordinary Day. Lenny Gallant for Without Love. Ron Hines, Godspeed. Sarah McLachlan, Building a Mystery. And Laura Smith, It's a Personal Thing.
And the winner is?
The winner is... The winner is Sarah McLachlan, Building a Mystery.
Accepting on behalf of Sarah McLachlan, Dave Holmes from Network Production.
Come out at night. That's when the energy comes. The dark side's light.
On behalf of Sarah and everyone at Network, thank you very much.
Among the awards presented during the pre-telecast portion of tonight's ECMAs, Super Friends, Alternative Artists of the Year. Late Romantics by Symphony Nova Scotia with Georg Tinkner. Picked up Classical Album of the Year. Video of the Year went to Building a Mystery, Sarah McLachlan, directed by Matt Mahorin. And the Johnny Favorite Swing Orchestra is 1998's Jazz Artist of the Year.
Look down like this, 50 cents to spare. Sometimes I stay out late, sometimes I wouldn't dare.
African Canadian Artist of the Year went to For the Moment. Instrumental Artist of the Year, we have two winners, Scott McMillan and Richard Wood.
Next, the People's Choice Entertainer of the Year, and Ron Hines with Symphony Nova Scotia.
Said, he used to live across the street from me. Him and his wife Connie make a mean turkey dinner. Ladies and gentlemen, with a tribute to Gene McClellan, please welcome a good neighbor and one of Canada's finest songwriters, Ron Hines.
Godspeed.
forgive a sweet soul a desperate deed. This was a prison and he was free. Godspeed. Godspeed. God bless. God bless. Was born out of sorrow. Speculation is anyone's guess. God bless. God bless. God only knows what takes a petal from the rose, what makes the dark rivers overflow, what makes a lifetime come and go. Put your hand in the hand of the man who must have believed he would understand. Forgive a sweet soul a desperate deed. Godspeed. Godspeed. God only knows what takes a petal from the rose, what makes the dark rivers overflow, makes a lifetime come and go. Goddamn, goddamn. You put your hand in the hand of the man who must have believed he would understand. Forgive a sweet soul a desperate deed. Godspeed. Godspeed.
Tonight's winners have earned the ultimate respect from their peers. The next winner is chosen by you, the fans. For the last few weeks, people have been phoning in their vote from Atlantic Superstores, Super Value, Save Easy, and Dominion stores in Atlantic Canada, where President's Choice products are sold. Our sincere thanks to President's Choice for their sponsor of this major award. And here to present the Entertainer of the Year Award are two artists from Newfoundland. She is working on her second major label release. He is a former Irish descendant about to release a new album with his new group, The Fables. Please welcome Davina Doyle and Darcy Broderick. How are you?
Well, I guess you could say that this is the big moment of tonight, given the fact that this award is the one that most artists would love to take home at some point in their career.
And for the past 3 years, Newfoundlanders have taken home this award. So that shows that we know how to entertain you. So please join us next year in St. John's for the 1999 yes. ECMAs.
Come and party on the rock. You want to do the image? And the nominees are...
Nominees for Entertainer of the Year are the Barra McNeils, the Johnny Favorite Swing Orchestra, Natalie McMaster, Great Big C, down, Sarah McLachlan.
Well, this is the big moment. And the winner is... Great Big C!
I've got a smile on my face and I've got four walls around me. Got the sun in the sky, all the water surround me. Sometimes I'm easy, I forgot it. To win this once would have been an amazing thing. To win it twice was an amazing thing. To win it three times is unbelievable. Thank you all very much. We have so many people we'd like to thank, starting with our families and women in St. John's, who've all waited faithfully through many a tour and through this evening tonight. We'd particularly like to thank Air Canada and Air Nova, who have allowed us to live in St. John's and play all around the world. Thank you.
Music, we got news for you. We've only just begun.
Coming up, Rita McNeil updates an East Coast classic. The 1998 East Coast Music Awards have been brought to you in part by Alexander Keith's India Pale Ale. Those who like it a lot. And by the province of Nova Scotia. Celebrate the best music in Canada all year long.
Well, that's just about it for the 10th annual East Coast Music Awards. Now, for those of you at home, tomorrow is a perfect day to go to your local record store and buy some great East Coast music. We think it's some of the best music this country has to offer. And to say goodnight, we appeared Ian McKinnon of Rollins Cross and John Morris Rankin with a musical legend. She is not only known and loved all over the world for the power and the beauty of her voice, she's also my very favorite target practice buddy. Please give a great ECMA welcome to Rita McNeil.
Fly away with you. Fly away.
peaceful waters flow.